Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next question. Okay, so this question belongs to GATE CSC 2014 set 2 guys. Okay, so the question is, consider the forward and store. Okay, so consider the forward and store packet network given below. Okay, so they give a small network below. Okay, assume that the bandwidth of each link is 10 power 6 bytes per second. So the bandwidth is 10 power 6 bytes per second. Okay, so a user host A. Okay, so a user host A wants to send a file size of 10 power 3 bytes to host B. Okay, so router 1 and router 2 in 3 different ways. Okay, so you want to send in 3 different ways. Okay, so in the first case, a single packet contains the complete file is transmitted from A to B. Okay, so in case 2, the file is split into 10 equal parts. Okay, and these packets are transmitted from A to B. Okay, in the third case, the file is split into 20 equal parts. Okay, from A to B. Okay, each packet contains 100 bytes of header information along with the user data. Okay, so consider only transmission time and ignore the propagation delay. Okay, so they are saying to ignore something. Okay, so queuing and okay, everything is ignored. Also, assume that there is no error during a transmission. Let T1, T2, T3 be their times corresponding to them. So which of the following relation is a true? Okay, so I think this question seems to be a bit interesting, right? Yes. So let us understand it carefully, guys. Okay, so what is the thing that we need to first calculate? Okay, so if I am going to send a single packet. Okay, so what is case 1? So case, okay, so they even told that the header, each packet contains 100 bytes header, right? Yes. Okay, so let us start. Okay, so what is the packet size, guys? Did they give the packet size anywhere? Yes. So the packet size is 10 power 3 bytes. That is nothing but 1000 bytes. Okay, so one more thing that you should understand here is, so every step here is a 3 time step, right? So basically, if I want to send a particular packet, and if I am considering only the transmission time, so here I need to place that packet, here I need to place the packet, here I need to place the packet, right? So I need to place it on the line, transfer, place it on the line, transfer, place it on the line, transfer. So indirectly, how many times I should place? 3 times. So as there are 2 intermediate nodes, I need to place it 3 times. So everything will be a multiple of 3 here, guys. Okay, so few students will be like, okay, so if it is everything is multiple of 3, we can avoid it, right? Yes, you are correct, but for our understanding, I think someone will be saying like, you forgot to multiply 3 and your answer is wrong. So that is the reason why I want to clarify it to you. Okay, yes, so let us take the first case. So T1. Okay, so what is the concept with respect to T1, guys? So what is first of all TT? TT is equals to length by bandwidth, right? Yes. So and one more thing is bandwidth is constant everywhere. So you, instead of substituting these values, based on that length only, you can identify the answer. So anything will work. But the only thing is, you should not do any silly mistakes, guys. That's it. Okay, yes. So let us start. Okay, so what is T1? T1 is nothing but it will be 3 into... So what is our packet size? First of all, it is 1000 bytes. And what is our additional header? It is 1000 bytes because we are sending only one packet in total. So it will be 1100 divided by 10 power 6 bytes per second, right? Yes. So if I convert it into milliseconds, it will be 10 power 3 milliseconds, right? Yes. So 3, 4, 5. So it will be 10 left. So it is nothing but 33 by 10. Which is nothing but 3.3 milliseconds, right? Yes. Okay. So now you got an idea, right? Yes. So now moving on to the second case. Okay. So that is a T2 is equals to. Okay. So now please concentrate for a few minutes, guys. Okay. Yes. So if you have already learned the concept of pipeline, it will be really easy. Okay. Yes. So anyway, I think it will be understandable. Please concentrate for some time. Okay. So assume that you want to send multiple packets. So basically, how many packets we will send now, guys? We will send a total of 10 packets, right? Yes. So if you recall, I told each packet will take 3 jumps, right? So from here to here, here to here, here to here. But when it comes to multiple packets, once this first packet jumped from here to here, the next packet will be here, right? Yes. So in the similar way, once this packet has been jumped here to here, this packet will be here to here, and the next packet, okay, and the next packet will be here. So in this way, the things will be done parallelly, right? Yes. So that is the major advantage when it comes to we are breaking it to multiple pieces. Okay. So here each packet will be of how much length, guys? If I divided this by 10, so each packet will be 100 length, and the extra data is 100. So in total 200 bytes is wasted, right? Yes. So first packet will take 3 into 200 bytes. Okay, into 10 power 6 bytes into 10 power 3 milliseconds plus, and the rest of 9 packets will take how much, guys? So 9 packets will take only 200, right? Yes. So there is no need of multiplication of 3 because they are running parallelly with respect to each other, right? Yes. Into 10 power 3 bits milliseconds 10 power 6 bits, sorry, bytes, okay, bytes 3 4 5 this all will be cancelled. 3, 4, 5, this all will be cancelled. Okay. So at the end, we are left out with 6 divided by 10 plus 9 2s are 18 divided by 10. So the result is 24 divided by 10. So the result is 2.4 milliseconds, right? Yes. So if you observe, by breaking the packets only, we were able to send the data fastly. Got it? Yes. So this is the advantage, guys, of the concept of pipelining. Okay. So pipelining is nothing but here parallelly everything is going on, right? Yes. So that concept is nothing but pipelining. Okay. Yes. So now let us calculate T3. So let me calculate it above because below we are not left out with any space, right? Yes. T3 is equals to, so if you recall, we divided it into 20 pieces. Okay. So I think each will be of 50, right? Yes, it is nothing but each is of 50. Due to the overhead, it is 150 now. So basically, the header part is a double of the packet size, right? Yes. Okay, so it is nothing but 3 into 150 into 10 power 3 milliseconds bytes divided by 10 power 6 bytes plus 3 into, sorry, it's not 3. So the left out pieces are 19, right? So 19 into 150 into 10 power 3 milliseconds bytes divided by 10 power 6 bytes. So bytes will cancel. Okay, so 3, 4. So basically it will be left out with 100 now. 3, 4. It will be left out with 100. Okay, so it is nothing but 13 into 5. It is, sorry, my bad. 15 into 3. It is nothing but 45. So this is 45 divided by 100 plus, what about this value, guys? It is nothing but 19. Okay. So 19 into 150. It is nothing. Sorry. It's 19 into 150. It is 2850 divided by 100. Okay. So if I add it plus 45 equal to. Okay. Did I do any mistake somewhere, guys? Okay. Yes. Anyway, let us continue. Divided by 100. Okay. So what is the result? So we got 28.95. Okay, so just give me a second, guys. I think I did some silly mistake. So let me check it once. So it is a 19 into 15. Okay. Just give me a second. 19 into 15 is 285 plus 3 into 15, which is 330. Okay. So what did I do mistake here? How did I get these values basically? Let me calculate it again. Okay, so 19 into 15, it is a 285. Okay, and the other value is a 3 into 15, which is 45. Okay, so let it be. So let us calculate it again, guys, because I'm doing some silly mistake there. So let us calculate it again. So basically, here, if you observe carefully, so this value. So let me write them again, guys. Okay. So the first part is a 3 into 150 into 10 power 3 milliseconds bytes divided by 10 power 6. So it is nothing but 3, 4. So basically, if I cancel 2 here, so 2 will be left out there, right? Yes. Plus 19 into 15 into 10 power 3 milliseconds bytes divided by 10 power 6. So here also same concept. So you will left out with the 2 bytes. So bytes will cancel. This bytes will cancel. Okay. So 19 into 15 plus 3 into 15. So the result is a 330. So 330 divided by 100. Okay. Divided by 100. Okay. So which is a nothing but a 3.3. Okay. So the silly mistake which I did is I wrote here 2850. Guys, it is 285 only. Okay. Yes. So that is a silly mistake. So we got a 3.3 milliseconds. So if you observe carefully, T1 is 3.3. T3 is also 3.3 and T4 is 2.4. So now if you observe carefully, option D is matching, right? So 1 and 3 are same and 3 is greater than 2, right? Yes. So option D is the correct answer. Got it? Yes. So now I hope everyone got a clear idea, right? Yes. So I hope everyone got a clear idea. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.